Standard operating procedures help us complete activities accurately. Whether it's to ensure thoroughness or compliance, they can be designed into your service desk. Let me show you how. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Service Desk, you can give agents as much flexibility and rigidity as you need. Essentially, InvGate Service Desk provides you with three different ways to include standard operating procedures, or SOPs, according to your goals and your process complexity. But before you can create standardized procedures in the tool, you need to design them. If you haven't downloaded our template already, you can find a free template in the description or on our website, invgate.com. Once your processes are designed, make sure to grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along. You should find a link in the description. Now, let's get started. You have three ways to build your SOPs into InvGate Service Desk. You can do it in the form of a list of predefined tasks, which is great for simple, linear processes. You can build procedures with workflows, which come in handy for more complex and cross-department or cross-team tasks. And you can also turn them into knowledge articles for reference during work. Let's walk through these options. And we'll start with the first one. Checklists and subtasks can either be added on the fly when resolving tickets. So for instance, if I see this here, I can add additional tasks on as whatever I need. Maybe I have to restart the printer. Maybe I need to restart the print spooler or the print server. Whatever it is, you can add those subtasks on the fly. For standard operating procedures, automation is of course the best option to ensure that they appear every time this type of request is submitted. You can add subtasks with automation. To do this, you'll log in as an administrator, go to Settings, and into Requests under the Automations option over here on the right. And we've got a bunch in here already, but I've got one specifically for computer hot swaps, because this is one of those things where we really need a checklist to make sure we do every single step. In here, you can see I've got a name, a description, what the new event is, and it's going to match these conditions. So on every new request, it's checking to see if the category is computer failure, and if it is, these are the actions that it's taking. So it's creating these tasks. Under the task creation option here, I can choose what my tasks are and how many there are. So here I've got just complete the hot swap to a new machine. That's not actually required. I can set a description, a due date, and assign it to a specific person if I need to as well. Then I've got my other things, run Save the State app, do the initial diagnosis, classify the wiped reason, wipe and put back in stock, and I can add additional tasks here. Now I like these, so I'm just gonna leave them. Once the checklist is automated, agents will see the tasks to complete right into the request. And here I've got a computer hot swap request that I've already started, and you can see the five tasks up here. Complete the hot swap, run save the date. And as I go through these and complete them, we start to see this progress bar progress, of course. And I, of course, know that my work is done on this subtask. So at this point, I could actually close this entire ticket and we're done. We're ready to go. So this is the easiest way to put standard operating procedures into your agent's workflow. Great for checklists, great for making sure that it works, great for linear work. For less linear work or requests that require multiple teams or groups of tasks to be done sequentially, workflows are the way to go. With workflows, we've got some pre-built ones in InvGate Service Desk. To get to workflows, you go to Settings, Requests, and then to Workflows. And I'm gonna pull up an employee onboarding workflow that comes with InvGate Service Desk. Now, this onboarding workflow makes it so that you can create a set of tasks and multiple instances of the process so that you can ensure that every subtask in any given stage is completed before the next team gets their tasks. So for instance, I've got two sets of tasks here, and I've actually added a third one for facilities that's not complete yet. These subtasks are going to be completed in groups. So this workflow step is all these tasks need to be completed before the next set of tasks get kicked off. And I can set that in the step itself. So for instance, I can allow to create tasks during the new workflow execution besides the ones that were created during configuration. And this is a stage to have predefined tasks. Then the tasks get visible to the end users. I've got that enabled, but it might not always be necessary. In this case, for onboarding, it makes sense. The line manager put in the request. They want to know how the laptop is going. They want to know how benefits setup is going. So we're going to let them see that. We are able to allow the workflow to proceed to the next stage without the need to complete all the tasks. So that's an important setting. If you want them to be completed in chunks, like I pointed out at the beginning of the workflow, this is where you want to set it. You want to turn this off so that all the tasks need to be completed from the previous step before the next step kicks off. Now, our employee onboarding is a little more flexible, so I'm just going to leave that. And you can also make it so that it copies uncompleted tasks to the next stage of the workflow. Pretty handy if you don't have to have everything done from one step in the next step. And then you can see the specific steps that I've got on this workflow for onboarding, pulling inventory, and you see a lot of the same automation, description, due date, and an assignment. Now this workflow then gets set as the workflow for the onboarding request catalog entry, and it will kick off every single time that that catalog entry is entered. You can do a ton with these workflows. You see, we've got web service calls out to create the Active Directory. You can put in additional forms. So even though there's an initial form where the line manager fills out, later after that new hire is approved, we then fill in another form for IT information. So you can see that these customize for however you want to do work. The third way to manage standard operating procedures in your service desk tooling is within knowledge articles. This is a particularly great thing to have in place for new agents and for requests or tasks that are less linear or require more guessing and trying. It's great for those sticky incidents, checklists that are still being developed. Here's an example of a ticket where I can search for our SOPs in the knowledge base. Here's that same ticket from before, and I can search for our SOPs in the knowledge base right here. I can just click on SOP, and typing an SOP is gonna bring up that specific knowledge article. I can pop it over the ticket, make sure that I'm following the standard operating procedure correctly, or if I need to, I can even attach this to the incident, but really I'm just gonna refer to this as part of my work. If you're in the process of working on your standard operating procedures, or you use procedures in your work, make sure you check out our blog post on standard operating procedures. There's some good advice in there and a free template to download. This is just one aspect of InvGate Service Desk that's designed to make automation and workflow easy, repeatable, and managed by your own service and support teams instead of a platform team. For more on this topic, subscribe to our YouTube channel or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.